welcome to the show. If you're just joining us, it's great to have your company. It's a busy morning. And we want to begin this hour with that major breaking news on the Optus data breach. The hacker responsible for the Optus cyber attack has just released the private information of 10,000 customers. In a post, the person writes, "Optus, if you are reading, the price for us to not sell data is $1 million. We give you 1 week to decide. If you care about your customers, you will pay." The person threatens that if the money is not paid, 10,000 records will be released per day until the money is received. Here's what a victim and also Jason Clare had to say this morning on Today.
The attacker was used the dark, dark web. So it's a really concern from my point of view, where I'm trying to protect my whole family and have had security measures in place for that. And it seems to be compromised now. So it doesn't leave me feeling very well.
Not only appalling, but, you know, for 10 million Aussies right around the country that have had their information effectively stolen, you know, they must be extraordinarily worried at the moment.
Yeah, it's all very terrible. Now, four teens have been charged over a hit and run in Brisbane, which killed a man. Today's Mia Glover is at the scene. Mia, the teenagers will face court.
Yeah, they certainly will, Sarah. Over the next couple of days, they'll be facing the Brisbane Children's Court. The eldest aged just 16 years old. Police claim it was mid-yesterday morning here on this busy road in Wynnum West that two 15-year-olds were behind the wheel of a stolen Nissan X-Trail. They were speeding, veering onto the wrong side of the road and hitting a 59-year-old moped rider. He was transported to the PA hospital in a critical condition, but overnight he has since passed away. Those two 15-year-olds, a boy and a girl, well, they legged it from the scene. They fled a few streets away. Police thankfully managed to catch up with them through help with the nearby public as well and some neighbours. Here's what police had to say.
It's both disappointing and frightening for the community at large. It's a tragic event for the male rider.
Another two teens, a 15 and 16-year-old, were also taken into custody along with those initial 15-year-olds. Another stolen car was also located nearby. Also, I just wanted to show you, this is the scene this morning. There has been a native floral bouquet that's been left by a local here. This just goes to show the community is absolutely reeling for this 59-year-old man's family. The man who laid this bouquet, he said he just wanted to give a silent prayer to the man and his family this morning. Sarah?
Yeah, it's awfully tragic, Mia. Thank you. Meanwhile, police are hunting for a P-plate driver in Sydney's southwest accused of hitting and killing a 57-year-old man yesterday. The father of four was walking to work in Fairfield when a black Honda Accord with green P-plates rolled through a stop sign, turned the corner, then sped up, hitting the man before driving off.
Doctors are fearing the worst for Shyla Rodden, who remains in hospital this morning in a critical condition nearly 2 days after an horrific accident at the Melbourne Royal Show. The 26-year-old was struck and dragged by a roller coaster carriage Sunday afternoon, the incident leaving dozens of showgoers in shock.
The carriage has come to an abrupt stop up the top, and I've just seen the person fall just straight forward and down. And I've seen her fall all the way to the ground.
I only saw the back of her, and I saw her laying there and the back of her head with a massive pool of blood. And everyone just went in shock. It was silent, nobody was moving, nobody knew what to do.
As WorkSafe and Victoria Police try and piece together exactly what happened, we'll hear from the CEO of the Royal Show right after the weather, coming up shortly. Two men are on the run this morning after allegedly robbing a service station in Western Sydney. The men, allegedly armed with knives, threatened an employee around 1 a.m. at the Lidcombe store before demanding cash and cigarettes. No one was injured during the theft. Let's go. The party is kicking on in Victoria this morning, with the Cats taking to the streets of Geelong for their parade. Geelong will save the day. Today's Isabella Staskowski is in Cats colours for the occasion. Is a good morning. I thought a tiger never changes its stripes. What's going on?
Alex, Tigers and Cats, they aren't really that different after all, are they? Especially when you think about the premierships over the years. But at the moment here in Geelong, you really have to wear this to actually get in. This is what everyone is wearing on the streets of Geelong at the moment. The party will continue a little later today. But of course, yesterday we saw the boys dressing up as elderly men. A bit of a play there. And all the critics who said they were too old and they'd be too slow. We saw Isaac Smith, of course, the oldest Norm Smith winner in history, even taking a bit of a tumble on purpose out of a bus that they'd hired from a retirement home to keep up the act. We know Paddy Dangerfield, it took him about 90 minutes in hair and makeup in order to look that grey, that old. So the boys having a lot of fun yesterday. Let's take a listen.
The weekend helped because we could have set ourselves up horribly.
I do like the comfy clothes. The legs are a bit swollen, so it's actually not too bad just rolling around on a cane.
Too old, too slow and too good.
And Alex, this is beautiful Geelong this morning. You can see that people are setting up here ahead of that parade. It is all kicking off at 11 a.m. That motorcade is going to go down the streets of Geelong for about a kilometre and a half. So a lot of fun indeed. And then there'll be a big ceremony again at about midday. So the party certainly does continue here in Geelong. It's about day four now. I think they could be even going into next week if they keep it up.
Yeah, stay safe, Izza. Things could get ugly.
They're still sleeping out in sleepy Geelong.
Yeah. It's going to be rocking.
Party town.
In not very long time. Thank you, Izza.
All right. Well, we are learning more this morning about the extent of the injury sustained by Melbourne woman Shyla Rodden after she was hit by a roller coaster at the city's royal show and thrown 9 metres. Her father saying, "There's hardly a thing that's not broken. I just can't work out how much damage has been done."
Imagine the pain that family you don't want to are going through right now. Yeah. Well, let's bring in CEO of Melbourne Royal Show, Brad Jenkins. Brad, I'm sure it's been an annus horribilis week for you. Do we know what happened yet?
Well, good morning, Carl and Sarah. I'd like to be joining you on better circumstances, yeah. But if I can just say first off, you know, it's been totally devastating, and our hearts go out to the young woman that was involved in that tragic accident and her family and friends and loved ones. You know, it's just totally devastating. And also, you know, our thoughts are also with all those bystanders that were innocently enjoying a great day at the show and, you know, happened to be there at the time of the scene. So in terms of what happened, you know, the early reports were from the police that she'd been on the ride a little bit earlier and dropped the phone, and at some stage went back to recover the phone and was tragically hit by the cart. Further details other than that, from what I've got from the police report, has been handed over to WorkSafe for further investigation. And I don't have any more details other than that, and I'll wait for the WorkSafe report to come back. But it's just a tragic accident that just shouldn't have happened.
Yeah, and Brad, as you say, you know, it's still sort of contested what actually happened. The police are investigating it. And I guess so many people are trying to understand how on earth, if she did try to reach her phone, how she could have even accessed that area while a ride is active.
Yeah, that's right, Sarah. So that's what, you know, that's WorkSafe's role, to go in and investigate what's happened in the tragic accident and get a better understanding of how it's happened and to make sure that you know, it doesn't happen again in the future.
Look, the problem with all this is that when something so tragic and awful happens to a family and they're told WorkSafe is investigating, it can sound and smell like a cover-up. What are you doing in order to allay those fears out there with the public, given so many people saw what happened?
Yeah, well, first of all, those that were on the scene, innocent bystanders at the time, you know, we're offering counselling to those. We're immediately after the incident, we had St John's Ambulance down with all those innocent bystanders taking care, just checking on their welfare. I mean, it would be a tragic thing to be there witnessing. But since then, we're also offering post-counselling for anyone that requires it. In terms of the rides themselves, I mean, we have stringent conditions in terms of all the signing off of all the rides at the Melbourne Royal Show and all events around Victoria. WorkSafe Victoria have very stringent protocols and make sure that all rides at events like the Melbourne Royal Show are the best and the safest.
Have you spoken to the family?
No, I haven't personally spoken to the family. It's not something I have done. I have spoken. You know, obviously there's a lot of people involved in terms of being affected by this and totally devastated, you know, from not only just the show operator himself, the whole show community is just totally devastated. So it's just a very tragic accident that I wish, you know, has not happened.
What do you say to the family?
As I said up front, you know, where our heart goes out to you. You know, I have a young daughter myself, and I totally understand how they'll be feeling, and it'll be totally devastating. And you know, our heart and thoughts go out to the family and their loved ones.